All right. Well, so. Yikes. I know a lot of you are thinking that we're about to go IMF. It's America that is crumbling economically. And I do blame a lot of that on the particular, well, the cheaper cost. You know, we went for the cheaper cost. You know, we went for the distributor who even only supplied the cheaper cost, that were not from America. They were not American-made companies. Now, you can also say straight away the American company label, you know, made in the USA, was a, what do we call it, a fail. What an ugly, ugly advertising campaign. I believe that was hokey. And initially, you know, it's just like, well, yuck. That advertising campaign made me even want to buy international. So we have to look straight away at recreating that advertising campaign on an American scale, make it more chic, make us the internationals. Do you understand? So we are not needing the chic elsewhere. So what's going on here is we have to scale back into our cute little continent here, scale back into it, back into the United States of America, put the companies that hire workers here in America back in business. And if it involves, we have to increase VATs, and well, they're not VATs here, the taxations on imports, then so be it. You know, we have allowed a gluttony of incoming from whatever. You know, if you can make a car for 10 cents, then you're welcome here, you know. This is how stupid the system has been. So we have to redirect it the other way. So the people here within this little community called the United States of America have jobs, they're working careers, okay? Now, to have the jobs and the working careers, that means they have to make the components, that means they have to make the items that go into the products that are sold here in America. All right? So now we have to make these costs viable. We have to make these costs viable and comparative. And they have to be chic also. So to make them viable, comparative, and chic, those are our main goals. Now, if we are going to make them comparative, we have to really think outside of the box, like quickly. We have to reduce how many managers are managing the system. Because actually, if we look at the, you know, a factory itself, it doesn't need that many managers, it's just how it's done. So like I said in the last few videos, the big screen TV, the big head management, whatever, is a marvelous way, you know. Yeah, okay, so we're more like a talk show event to the workers, that's fine, with some kind of intercom system that they can bing into if they have to discuss directly. So that reduces it already, so that you can reduce your managers, so we won't have as many managers. However, we will have managers, whereas before we didn't even have them in employ. So before, maybe you had three managers, we will only have one, but it at least will be a manager, okay, here in the United States employed. So nextly, other ways. I'm looking at combining, because I know the advertising budget is one of the biggest, largest gluts on a company that just will just expose them into poverty pretty quickly. So we're looking at joining companies together. And when I say not joining the companies together, merging them, but as an advertising bond. an advertising bond situation. So like you would take Southwest Airlines, you would take Snowbird, and you would take the RMC Motor Car Company with a star. You put them all together. So they share the advertising costs. So when we want to do and hit big television, whatever, we're there and we're able to be committed into that payment, because those are expensive. So we have to reduce our costs. This is, remember, we're trying to remain viable and comparative cost-wise with other cheap manufactured areas of the planet. Manufacturing areas. What else was I about to say? Yeah. And so now we're able to hire the American workers. We're able to put new jobs out there, new careers out there that were given away, that are done in other areas of the planet. Okay, so now we have new, fresh hold on the property market. These people, with each new, let's say it's a car company, we're going with this RMC star, we have this new car company. Now it can create all kinds of different models. All kinds. Now, so the momentum of it is also the other companies that it supports. You know, you have the radio company. You have an American car radio company. Let's say there's 1,500 workers there per 25,000 cars. That's another 1,500 workers that were not here in America. So you keep adding up another car, another addition that goes into that car that we would be normally buying outsource. You know, so if we can get those radios cheaply, get those radios as cheap as, if we can get those, you know, right here in America. Do you understand? So then now we have 1,500 other workers that are supporting the property market also, that are able to pay, you know, their mortgage. So it continues and it continues and it continues. So every little facet, even the material, the bulk material that is used for the car seats themselves, purchased right from a company of America. So I'm really getting serious about in-house. Can we do this in-house? You understand the difference. We have to be chic and we have to be in-house America. A long time ago, even though it was that, remember that Love American style and had the little cutesy? Yeah. It really is that, you know, we really have to get back to Love American style with what we're out here purchasing, or we're just, I'm sorry, we're just going to be like Venezuela pretty quick. I mean, it's too much of a tump too soon, you know, too quickly. The old Dow. So we're going to have to ship up really quickly, and I'm already promoting the taxation increase on imports, and I know we've gone with this fair trade and it's going to affect things, but there's just no way. I mean, if there's a car here that's built in America and it's 25,000, and there's a car that's built elsewhere for the same price, we have to get taxation. So that car coming in is going to be 28. It's just not fair. It's not fair to us as an economic structure. Otherwise, we're going to fail. You know, you cannot keep giving your business away. Give your profits away, you give your business away, you lose your people. You lose your economy. You know what I'm saying? All right, so I didn't mean lose your people, but yeah, you lose your economic stance of who they are, you know. We just become a, you know. Anyway, so I think you all understand what I'm trying to say. But chic it up. We have to chic up American products and not be that stupid label. Yeah.